Hi everyone, welcome to fullstackmania. In this video we are going to learn about global exception handling with Spring Boot. So I have created a student service where I am doing all the four CRUD operations. So this is the get mapping, this is the post mapping, this is the put mapping, and this is the delete mapping. Okay, so the flow is we are calling this endpoint from postman, and this endpoint is calling the service, and inside the service we are doing all the database operations, and the database layer is injected over here. So in the service, this is the method which is called when you try to get a student with the help of the ID. So if the student is not available in the database, then we are throwing a custom exception called StudentNotFoundException. Now, if you go to the postman and send a request to the student ID 10, which is not available in the database, we are returning a 500 internal server error, which doesn't make any sense for the client. The client will not get anything out of this message. So we have to return a message which the client can understand. So let's create our error response model. Let's create a class, new class, and the class name will be error response, and hit enter. Okay, now I am going to write two variables. One is the local date time, which is a timestamp, and the second variable will be the suitable message. So I'll write it private string message. Okay, so these are the two variables which we are going to use. Now we have to write @noArgumentConstructor and @allArgumentConstructor as we are using Lombok, and we have to give the getters as well. Okay, so this is our error response model. So whenever we will get any exception, we have to return the timestamp, and we are returning the suitable message. Okay, now to handle the exception globally, I am creating a class called GlobalExceptionHandler. So I'll write it GlobalExceptionHandler and I'll hit enter. Okay, now let's extend this class from ResponseEntityExceptionHandler. Okay, so this will be the base class, and we will annotate this class with controller advice. Okay, now if you remember, we were throwing student not found exception. Now we have to catch this exception. So to catch this, we have to write @ExceptionHandler, and inside it we have to give which exception we want to catch. So we will write student not found exception dot class. Okay, now let's create the method. So we'll write the method public. We are returning a response entity of object, and we'll give the method name as student not found response. Okay, and let's give the method arguments. We have to pass the exception, and we have to pass the web request. So I have passed the web request, and now Spring Boot is responsible to inject the exception and web request. We have to focus only on the business logic. We are not going to inject anything. Okay, so let's instantiate our response model. So we have to pass error response. Error response is equal to new error response, and the first argument is the local date time. So we'll write local date time dot now, so current time. And the second argument is the suitable message. So we'll write ex exception object dot get message. So this will give the cause of the exception. Now at the end, we can return the response entity with the help of a method which is inside response entity exception handler, which is return handle internal exception. Okay, so we'll write handle exception internal. And we are passing the exception. The second argument is the error response. The third is the HTTP header. The fourth one is the HTTP status. And we can pass the HTTP status as not found, because student not found exception. Okay, so we can write HTTP status dot not found, which is 404. And the last argument is the request, which is the web request we got. Okay, so with this, we are done with our first global exception handling. Okay, and let's start the application and let's test this. Okay, so let's give a couple of minutes and let's go to postman. And if you send the request, then we are getting that student not found with ID 10. If you change the ID to something else, let's say 50, and send the request, then we are getting student not found with ID 10. And the timestamp is also changing with request. Similarly, for the post API, we are passing the student object as a method argument, and we are validating the request body. And if the student name is blank, then we are sending the response that student name cannot be blank. Okay, so but if you go to postman and see if the name is blank and we are sending the request, we are getting 400 byte request, which is fine, but we are not getting any response back. So the client may not know what is going on the server. So to fix this, let's go back to our code. Let's go to the error response class, and here we will add another variable. Okay, that variable will only holds good to return the results if we have binding related errors. Okay, so here I will write list of string filled errors, and I'll initialize is equal to new array list. Okay, and I'll give the getters for the newly added field. Okay, so let's add the getters. Fine, we are done with this. Now we are going to add this field errors to the response if the field is not null. If it is null, then we are not going to add it to the response. To achieve this, we have to write an annotation at the rate JSON include. JSON include, JSON include dot non null. Okay. So if this field is null, then we are not going to add it to the response. Now let's go back to the global exception handler, and for the student not found exception, we don't have any binding errors, right? So for the error response, let's pass the third argument as null so that it will be working as expected. And let's come back to our post API scenario. So let's go to the student controller, and here if you see, if we have at the rate valid annotation and this validation got failed, then in the response entity exception handler class, there is one method which is getting triggered, and that is the method argument not valid exception dot class. Okay, so let's find out which method it is calling. It is calling the this method. Okay, handle method argument not valid. So let's copy this, let's paste it over here, and we don't have to write at the rate exception handler for this method, because this exception is already getting caught in the response entity exception handler. So we have to only override this method. So the conclusion is, if a method is not getting caught in response entity exception handler, like student not found exception, then we have to write at the rate exception handler. If an exception is getting caught in response entity exception handler, then we just have to override it. Now let's write the exception. Okay, so we have to write exception dot get binding result. It will give all the binding results, and we can assign it to a new variable called result. Okay, now let's write result dot get field errors. Okay, so it will give the first field error, but there may be a chance that we will get multiple field errors. Okay, so let's convert it into list of field errors. Okay, and let's convert it to result.getFieldError so that we will get all the field errors. Okay, now let's iterate through the field error. So let's write for each field error, error inside field error. So this is the for each syntax. Error inside field error, we have to add it to a list of string. So let's create a list of string, error is equal to new array list. We are initializing the array list, and let's add it to the, okay, so let's convert it to errors, and let's write errors dot add. Inside the error, there is one method called get default message. So let's write error dot get default message. Okay, so this default message is going to hold the custom message which we are giving in the bin. So here it will hold this student name cannot be blank message. Okay, now we added all these things to the list of string errors. Okay, now let's initialize the error response. So error response is equal to new error response, and the first variable will be the local date time. So let's write local date time dot now. So this is the current time. The second variable is the string message. As we know, it is a bad request, right? Because method argument doesn't satisfy it. So let's just write bad request, and the third argument is the errors which we have already passed it. Okay, now in the handle exception handler method, the first argument is the exception, The second argument we can pass as the error response. The third argument is the header. The fourth one is the status, which we don't have to change, because in the response entity exception handler, for this exception, the status is already bad request. So we don't have to do any changes for it. So we are done with our coding part. So let's stop the application. Let's go to stop the application and let's start the application. Okay, let's keep some time for the application and let's go to Postman and let's send the request. Now you can see the response we are getting is student name cannot be blank and the error code is 400, which is the client can understand and it's a valid response. So the source code link is in description, and if you like this video, then please like, share and subscribe. Thank you.